This is Power BI and More from CRM Audio. This episode is brought to you by CRM EG. The Dynamics 365 user group is the world's most influential user group community of Microsoft Dynamics 365 and CRM users and partners. Across the globe, members share a common goal of maximizing and advancing the performance of Microsoft Dynamics 365 and CRM so that individuals and companies can improve operations, overcome obstacles, and exceed goals. We thank CRMUG for sponsoring Power BI and More. So Ulrich, I understand you have some breaking news for us, something new and exciting. What is that?
Right. So my friend Mohammed and I that I made the advanced chart editor for the XM toolbox with, where we made the additional setting where you can work with all the properties on the charts, we have actually now released a new tool, still in beta, semi-preview, called the Power Query Builder, which guess what, helps you build a Power Query code that you can basically cut and paste directly into your Power BI query editor using all your metadata from Dynamics 365, so you don't have to sit and select the individual entities and the individual fields, etc. There are some accelerators in there that basically picks up all the data, the field names, and you can use views and other things to basically pre-make that query. And it selects all the fields that you want and renames them. And then we have a lot of additional features coming. That's why I'm saying it's a bit beta, still in preview a little bit, because we do want to add more features to it. We want to have it a lot easier to be working with option sets, for example. That's one of the hurdles that's difficult to get over. Changing names, especially working with data types and presetting the data types. So a lot of those features that you otherwise would like spend a lot of time doing, I call it the boring work of working with Power BI, where you just sit and select fields and you rename them and you set the data type and all that stuff, we can kind of get out of the way and you'll get to the fun stuff, which is putting it inside a report and making some great visuals on it.
Okay, so instead of using the standard Power BI or Power Query wizard, you would use this tool. And what are you starting with? You just connecting to Dynamics? Is it similar to the Fetch XML builder and you're selecting your objects in there and building the query?
It's fairly similar to the Fetch XML builder. And it's also kind of similar to the Power Query accelerator that Sonoma Partners had out at one point. Which is
so
no
you
longer
can't get
available.
Anymore?
Yeah, which is no longer available, unfortunately. So we're taking some of the same features from there and adding a lot of new stuff to it. So you basically select your fields, everything that you want from Dynamics, and the tool will generate the M code or the Power Query script that you basically just take and cut and paste into a blank query inside Power BI, and it'll contain the connection string and all of those things in there.
You mentioned renaming fields. What's that about?
So Power BI only understands schema names of everything that you're doing inside Power BI. And of course, Power BI is intended as a reporting end user perspective. So the people who will be looking at the reports in the end will have no idea what all those schema names mean. So a part of the what I call the boring work was you basically have to sit and rename all of your fields from, you know, estimated value, all lowercase one word, to, you know, estimated revenue, etc., what it's called on the opportunity, for example. So people will know what kind of data they're looking at and they're familiar with the data structure.
So instead of new underscore account type, you can just name it account type.
Right. It'll be automatically be named account type for you, so you don't have to worry about that.
Got it. But if you want, can you alias it if you want to call it something different to make more sense?
If you want to call it something else inside your Power BI model, you just go through the standard steps. But it's basically providing the data model, at least on a per-table basis, as it is inside Dynamics.
Okay. So where can we get this exciting new tool, and how do you want people to give you feedback on it so you can make it even better?
Right. So as I mentioned, we're definitely looking for feedback at this point. So one place to start is on my blog, crmchartguide.com. And watch the quick introduction video on there. But otherwise, if you just want to play around with it, you open up your XM toolbox, you go to the plug install, and you type in Power Query or Power BI, and you'll see the Power Query Builder in there. Just
great.
Ready to download.
Great. So we'll put a link to that in the video in the show notes, so you can check that out to get a link directly to it. That's great to hear that. I'll check that out. So the other topic, which has been on everybody's mind these days, is Power Apps, and specifically, how can you leverage Power Apps, Canvas apps, with Power BI?
Right. So are you ready for Inception?
The dream within the dream within the dream?
Within a dream, yes.
Yeah.
So when we use Power Apps within Power BI, working with Dynamics 365 data, and if we include the data export service in that, if we start with that product, we can have a report showing information from Dynamics 365. And as you know, you can make selections within the report. You can click on an account. You can click on a customer. You can select multiple activities, etc. You can have, inside your report, you can have a Power App which automatically filters down to the data that you are selecting inside your report. So those two are connected. So the Power App sits inside your Power BI report and shows you the selected data that you have. So it's either all of it or just based on the selections that you make. So you can select an account, a contact, you can select, you know, expenses for approval, etc., and then trigger or make, do whatever it is that you want to do inside your Power App and have it update things back inside Dynamics 365.
So the big why here is so you can make your visualization and report and dashboard actionable, right? So I can,
yes,
I can do something. I can not only see the data, but you can provide an interface via the Canvas Power App to let me make updates to it.
Right. And it lets you, and using those two combined, it lets you make selections to the data and filter the data in a manner that just wouldn't be possible inside Dynamics 365. Where we have the different visuals, you know, you can click on one visual, you hold down control, you click on the other visuals, and you can just keep on narrowing down your filter set depending on your selections, just clicking through, and then you have, you know, your small subset of record or one record, etc., that you want to update from the Power App, and you can select it from there and basically just run your Power App. Or you can do multiple selections within the Power App. You can select the specific records that you want. You can select the one record that you want to update and trigger the Power App from there. So the question is really, everything that you can do with a Power App, you can do from inside Power BI. Power BI helps you narrow down or filter it down to the correct data that you want to update.
That's really cool.
You're getting a very powerful and very visual tool in order to be able to do that.
And if thinking about it, the other really exciting thing about that option is this gives you the 300-some connectors that Power Apps have that you can now bring into your Power BI as well. So you can use the connector to OneDrive, Dropbox, all the different great connectors that they have, and Flow as well, and bring that into your Power BI dashboard. That's pretty exciting.
Right, and the reason I was making the Inception reference was because when we're looking at this, I'll find it interesting. So and when I demo this too, and I have the Power App and we see the Dynamics 365 data in there, the journey that data takes in order to end up in the Power App, because sometimes I have Dynamics 365, that's my source, that's what I want to update in the end. That data is transferred or copied onto an Azure SQL database via the data export service. Then I have my Power BI report running off that database. And then I have my report visualized through Power BI, which is actually then showing not the Dynamics 365 data per se, but a copy of it. Then I have that connected to the Power App that then can update the information back into Dynamics 365, even though that's not the original source.
And
it's also one of the reasons you want to make sure you have the ID included all the time so you can find that record again.
And the fact that you've got with version 9.0.2, the common data service is the same database as Dynamics 365, your Canvas Power App can be showing a real-time view into Dynamics data as well. So, you know, maybe you have something that is, you know, updated very frequently, you might get a faster connection through the Power App, you know?
Right. That's true. You may be able to show some late items. However, when you show that, I gotta be careful there. When you show the Power App inside the report, you have to connect it to your Power BI data set. which could be from an Azure SQL database. I mean, it could be, you know, could be a few minutes old.
So the Power App isn't reading from a different data source. It has to read from the same data source as your as your Power BI does. Yep.
It is connected directly to the data that you're viewing inside the report, which is why when you do the filters, you click on an account, a contact, and you filter the data down, you can actually see the Power App. If you have a list of records, you can actually see the data filtered down live to, based on your selections inside the report.
So then does that mean that if you have the embedded Power App updating Dynamics records, that you still need to use the Flow connector? Can you not use the CDS connector to update the data directly then?
Yeah, the source is going to be different. So the Power Apps connector will want to go back and update the original source, which you can't because that's coming from Power BI. So you would go back, you would use Flow to go back and make your updates inside Dynamics 365.
Okay.
I don't believe that Power Apps by itself is able to do that, just based on having the IDs, but Flow can do that.
Okay, that's cool. And the connector, the way you do it, it's a standard control, right? You don't have to do any kind of custom coding to embed a Power App.
So it is a standard control. One thing is, so it's not a part of the controls that you get out of the box that's included. But if you click on the little dot, 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 but the ellipsis under all the visuals you have inside Power BI, you can download it from the Microsoft Custom Visuals Marketplace. It's one of the Microsoft connectors. It is still in preview. So obviously there'll be more features coming to it. It's been in preview for a number of months now, I think 4 or 5 months. So we'll see when it actually comes out of the preview state. But you can add it in there, and you can start adding information to it, or just adding the data to the Power App. The same way that you add fields to a column chart or something else, you just drag over the fields that you want included inside the Power App. And of course, one thing you have to do in advance, though, is that you have to create a Power App that you want to work with. So you want to know what to do, you create the Power App, whatever it needs to do, at least the part of it where you can see the data come in, so you can start working with it inside the application.
Okay. So if I have a Power App that I create that I intend to embed in Power BI, can I also have that same app used outside of Power BI, or the fact that it uses the filter, is it dependent on being called from within a Power BI dashboard?
So it is not dependent specifically on the Power BI dashboard or from the Power BI report. You can use it in any other context. You're basically just passing the name. So when you're passing the full name or contact name or et cetera, what it is that you want to the Power App, wherever that may be picking up the information from would work. So you're not making them specifically for the Power BI report, or not necessarily specifically for the Power BI report. I think, though, that would make sense, because once you start working with the app itself and the sizing and the size of the Power App and the structure of it, you can see that it would make sense to do the interface a little bit differently inside the Power BI report than you probably normally would inside if it was a phone app or a standard web app, for example. So
yeah,
you
want
to customize
it to
where you see it.
I can imagine that if you are doing it inside of a Power BI dashboard versus building an app for use on a mobile phone, for example, the placing of the menus and the borders you might use you might want to adjust that. I don't think putting the arrows in the exact same place and having maybe the same number of screens you go through if you're using it within a dashboard might make as much sense.
Right, and you can also make like the immediate selection where if you select a specific account, you can have the Power App already filtered down to that account when you go see it on the report, so it's already on the account, and you just make your selections from there. And of course, Yasan, when you're designing your report, the standard phone view of the Power App basically messes with all the reporting standards and trying to fit it in somewhere. So you probably want to change up the structure or the format of the report.
But that's the good thing about Canvas apps. You basically can do whatever you want with the layout.
Right. Exactly.
And that's where we've recently, some of the MVPs and people in the Dynamics community have recently figured out ways to embed Canvas apps inside model-driven apps and Dynamics 365. And that's exciting as well. There's not so much of an easy embedded control yet, but you can embed them. I believe some people have successfully got it to work with iframes and things like that. And there's code samples published from JavaScript if you want to embed a Canvas app inside of a form, which is something I think is really exciting. That's when we can potentially look at maybe replacing dialogues with a Canvas app.
You know, I still like dialogues, but I have to admit that they are going away. They've been deprecated for a while now, and this is definitely coming. And I think now we're really starting to see how the Power Apps is going to work within the entire environment and all between all the different services and solutions, and how we can work it and have the same Power App either within Dynamics 365 or from Power BI or a combination of the two. One of my demos that I've been doing is actually showing the Power App inside Dynamics 365, inside a report that's a Power BI report embedded inside Dynamics 365. So you basically already filter down to a specific customer.
Then you really Dynamics, have the dream inside the dream inside exactly. The dream inside the dream.
And then I have the Power App in there. I make my additional selections, and I can basically run my updates from there, trigger flow, and basically do anything that flow would be able to do. So it's really starting to come together. I remember seeing like the initial demos here 6 months ago or a long time ago, and a lot of the Power Apps, at least some of the demos I saw, was introduced more something that, you know, would be feature specific, done internally. It wasn't necessarily something that you would work with doing so much during an implementation, but more something that employees would work with. They had like, you know, one feature they wanted to share within a small team of like four or five people, etc. Whereas the way that we are seeing Power Apps now and how you can really build it into the interface of the product and can trigger all of these additional features basically opens the door for a whole new set of controls and features, etc., that we have access to all of a sudden.
Yeah, I think it's exciting. It's also a little scary to me because it kind of goes away with what we've taught so long about standard interfaces and making sure everything works the same everywhere. This really opens the door to have some really funky, you know, one-off experiences when you get to certain entities. And so I think you still want to think about the overall experience. But no, I think that's great. And I think it's exciting because I can really see where, you know, somebody like an executive that has very little they want to update and change, and they more want to see a visualization, but they still occasionally want to update something. You know, yep. You could make a really simple interface that has a dashboard and then just has a couple fields that they can update and gives them everything that they need.
Yeah, something as simple as just requesting an update, for example, and see, you know, what's going on with this account, what's going on with this customer.
Or a simple give us some feedback form, you know, that could somebody viewing the dashboard could fill out three or four suggestion fields or question fields, and you could capture that in an entity somewhere that you could look at to have a feedback loop.
Right. Exactly. For what would make this report better? There's one thing I noticed here when we're setting all of this up, and I was kind of looking through some of the limitations of the Power Apps, so people don't necessarily start, you know, oh, maybe we can use this in the mobile app, because it's actually not supported on the mobile app, supposedly. So I was looking through the documentation to see if, you know, does it work on mobile, etc. And I actually didn't read the documentation until after I tried. So I actually just went ahead and opened up Power BI on my mobile phone on the Power BI app and had a look. And it's actually rendering just fine on the mobile device as well, even though it's supposedly not supported. So handle
not supported doesn't mean doesn't work.
Right, but you would think when it says that it's not supported, you would expect it to not display on the mobile app. I don't know. But
yeah, I don't know. There's things that are not supported with Dynamics that work. They're just not supported. I mean, you can run an SSRS report on an iPad, but it's not supported.
Right.
So great. That's exciting, and just again further opens the door for some exciting ways to not only visualize, but make your visualizations more active.
Exactly, and really work with the data, filter down, and help Power BI to not just be a reporting point, but becoming a part of the tool that you work with on an everyday basis.
So your assignments, listeners, are to go check out the beta of the Power Query Generator, and then embed some Power Apps within your Power BI. Power Apps plus Power BI, that's a lot of power right there.
Right. And once we get a little further down the road, maybe you can embed these inside the Dynamics 365 Outlook app. So when you get an email, you see the report, you see the Power BI report, you can make your selections and trigger something on the Power app, all from within Outlook.
I like it. Well, thanks, Ulrich.
The possibilities are endless.
All right. Well, thanks, Ulrich.
All right. Thank you, Joe.